Yeah, give me the words and I got the flow. See, I don't gotta write, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, that's called a ghostwriter. Jeremiah 5 and 14, that's so fire. Isaiah 14 and when I retire, out of captivity, I broke the iron. Who that is coming out of Mount Zion? Woolly hair, looking like a lion.
1,000 men marching with no drums on, no trombone, just boots on. Use our voices screaming out, take care of your homes, take care of your wives, take care of your own.
Now we standing out here in the valley of the bones. This place called America, this is not your home. This is like a tomb, place where you died at. Now I resurrected, trying to bring the 12 tribes back.
I came on a slave ship and
I ain't even like that.
Put my neck in the rope and
I couldn't even fight back. Sold on an auction
block, took a man. Hey, so let's get into it, man. How prideful Esau is, man. Go to Sleepy Joe, man. Look what he just recently said. Go to that. Go ahead.
We just have to remember who in God's name we are. We're the United States of America. And nothing is beyond our capacity if we work together. We've never failed to accomplish a goal we've set. Never, never, never.
Mm. They've never failed at anything. Keep it in Obadiah verse 1, man.
There you go.
They've never failed at anything that they have set their mind to accomplish. Okay. Read that in the Obadiah verse 1 down to 3.
Obadiah verse 1.
Bring it out.
The vision of Obadiah. Thus saith the Lord God concerning Edom.
Edom is the white man of America and all over the world. All right.
That's right. We have heard a rumor from the Lord, and an ambassador is sent among the heathen. Arise ye, and let us rise up against her in battle. Behold, I have made thee small among the heathen.
Small means hated. Go ahead.
Thou art greatly despised.
Uh-huh.
The pride of thine heart hath deceived thee.
That's what you just saw out of Sleepy Joe's mouth, man. The pride of thine heart, it deceived this white man. And I'm going to show you some videos of where he's been deceived and the pride that is evident to everybody on the face of the earth. And we'll have to go into this a little bit later at another time, man. We got to run it short on time, all right? We're going to skip that Monroe that we was at. Go to the next video. Let me see. Pull it up. Let's pull it up real quick. Just pull it up. All right, so let's play that.
I know country can beat the United States of America in a war. One of the United States' many advantages is its geographic location. There are truly vast expanses of this country in all different types of terrain, from densely forested mountains to scorching deserts. The U.S. military has a defense budget of $766 billion U.S. dollars. It alone makes up a third of all money spent on the military in the world. Only 20 countries have a larger GDP than the U.S. defense budget. Even if you are able to cross the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean to get to the United States and defeat all their allies and even somehow defeat their military, you would still lose. You want to know why? There are 120 firearms for every 100 American citizens, and American citizens are fighters. Most of them would do anything for the country, and it's simply in their blood ever since the beginning. Here is...
Now, let it play one more time. I'm going to show y'all something. Let it play.
Why no country can beat the United States of America in a war. One of the United States' many advantages is its geographic location. There are truly vast expanses of this country in all different types of terrain, from densely forested mountains to
scorching. Right there. It said its location, right? Now go to that Monroe Act video. Mm-hmm. It says one of its advantages is that its location. Now play the Monroe Doctrine or Act video. If you never heard of it, you're about to learn about it real quick and see what it is. And I'm going to give you a scripture on how that's biblical. Go ahead.
You know, the Americans have the Monroe Doctrine. I don't know what you know about the Monroe Doctrine, but the Monroe Doctrine basically says the Western Hemisphere is our backyard. And no distant great power, which means no great power from Europe or from Asia, is allowed to put military forces in the Western Hemisphere.
Stop right there. That's the Monroe Doctrine. That's why you don't see any Russian embassies, any China embassies or things, or military bases. You know what they call, what do they call those in the scriptures? Garrisons. Mm-hmm. Right. That's what those are. You don't see any military garrisons here in America because America said we own the entire Western Hemisphere. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
This side of the earth is ours. Dang. Nobody is beside us. Give me that in Isaiah chapter 47. I told you I was going to show you where it's in the Bible, right? This is how you know that this place right here is Babylon the Great. Give me the Isaiah 47, verse 1, and then we're going to jump. Go ahead, read that.
Isaiah chapter 47 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Come down and sit in the dust, O virgin daughter of Babylon.
Virgin daughter of Babylon. Go to Psalms 137 real quick so we can tie it together. Sit in the dust, virgin daughter of Babylon. Who is God referring to as the daughter of Babylon? What race of people? Go ahead.
Psalms chapter 137 and verse 7.
Uh-huh.
Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom.
Edom is the white man of America and all over the world. What did God call them? Go ahead.
In the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it. Raise it even to the foundation thereof.
Uh-huh.
O daughter of Babylon.
God called the white man the who?
The daughter of Babylon.
Because if you know anything about ancient Babylon are the Ethiopians. Those is a black race right. people. But God said this is the daughter of them. Why? Because they are in the midst of confusion just like ancient Babylon was. Now go back to Isaiah. Now that we know the virgin daughter of Babylon is the white man of America and all over the world, Isaiah chapter 47, and I want you to read verse 7 and 8. Watch this.
Isaiah chapter 47 and verse 7.
Read it out.
And thou saidest, I shall be a lady forever.
That's where you get your Statue of Liberty from, right? And it's America represents herself as a woman. Go ahead.
So that thou didst not lay these things to thy heart.
Uh-huh.
Neither didst remember the latter end of it.
Now listen to this. Pay attention. What he just said, the Monroe, where we are by ourselves, we own the West, mm-hmm. Western Hemisphere. There are no garrisons of another major power over here. Read.
Therefore, hear now this, thou that art given to pleasures,
uh-huh.
that dwellest carelessly.
Dwellest carelessly, meaning that you do whatever you want to.
Right.
For what reason? Read.
That sayest in thine heart, I am, and none else beside
Hold
me.
On. I'm what?
I am, and none else beside me.
What did that white dude just say? The Monroe mm-hmm. Doctrine? We go back and play it again, because you missed it. You missed it, what it said. I am, and none dwelleth beside me, or none else beside me. Play it again.
Is our backyard.
Run it back.
And no distant great
power. Okay, it's good, it's good. Go ahead.
Atmosphere is our backyard. And no distant great power, which means no great power from Europe or from Asia, is allowed to put military forces in the Western Hemisphere.
Pause it. Mm. Read that part again.
Verse 8. I am and none else beside me.
That's the Bible. They dwell as by their self. There's nobody beside them. That's why they can talk that prideful stuff that they speak, because there's no relative threat on this side of the earth. Because they had put it in their clause or whatever, establishing the country, no European power shall set up against next to us. No military garrisons. Yet and still, they have military garrisons all over Europe, right?
Hey, Amy.
Go ahead.
Oh, no. Go ahead, Cam. You can have some more.
No, go ahead. What
with that, I'm glad because that makes them a big target for the Lord.
Yes.
Can I get a scripture?
Yeah, bring it.
Go to Jeremiah 49, verse 16, real quick. With them, they don't even know how, by them doing that, they just made themselves a big target, an easy target for the Lord. Read that.
Jeremiah chapter 49 and verse 16.
Uh-huh.
Thy terribleness hath deceived thee.
Mm. Have what?
Hath deceived thee.
They have deceived themselves. Go ahead.
And the pride of thine heart.
Their what?
The pride of thine heart.
All you saw is that that's their pride. Yeah, and their military, nobody can beat them. Nobody can compare to them. Read.
O thou that dwellest in the clefts of the rock.
Because you know who he's talking about. Mm-hmm. Edom. Right? Read on.
That holdest the height of the hill.
Come on.
though thou shouldest make thy nest as high as the eagle,
come on,
I will bring thee Woo! Down.
The Lord promises he will bring you down.
There you go. Go now. Look how much That's more this right. pride in their spirit. This is how you know we're trying to convey to y'all that are listening that the white man, the Caucasian, American, Russian, French, they are Edom of the Bible, and they are the prideful that God hates. Play the next video. Listen to this pride. Watch this, Cap. Play that. Yep.
You want to talk about why the Western societies will not fall? I'll give you a couple examples. The F-15, the F-16, the F-22, the F-35, M1 Abrams tank, the Blue Water Navy, the KC-135, the KC-10, the ICBM structure.
You're saying all the money we spend on defense.
And the global positioning system. You want to come for us, you more than welcome to. The United States dollar is backed by the military, and as much as you guys want to sit there and complain, I'll say this right now. There is one country on this planet that has stealth capability. There's one country on this planet that I think has functioning ICBMs. I don't think Russia has a single functioning ICBM. And there is one country on this planet that actually has a functioning Blue Water Navy. There's only a few countries on this planet that have air refueling capability. And the only reason why they have them is because we sold it to them. If you guys want to come for us, you can. The United States could take on every country in the entire world militarily at the same time would be fine. Now, if you want to say Damn. Cyber terrorism or there's a moral decay from the inside,
man, cool.
make that argument. The United States is not going to fall, not in our lifetime, not in the next 20 lifetimes.
Wow.
Whatever you want. It just seems to be this buzzword that I hear on YouTube all the time about how Western society is going to fall. The morality that you want to instill, that is on your neighborhood, that is in your block, correct. And that is in your house. As a Christian man, I will raise my there kids that correct way. At the same time, I am not going to be so naive as to look to the world and wonder when are we going to swing back to our old Christian values, because it is not going to happen.
There you go.
Stop. And that is why God is going to destroy this place.
Hey.
Play it gets worse. The pride of thy heart have deceived thee. Play the next video. Go ahead.
Move. Iran, Russia, China, North Korea, ISIS, Al-Qaeda. They may be watching this right now. We don't care what you look like. We don't care who you voted for, who you worship, what you worship, who you love. It doesn't matter if your dad left you millions when he died or if he knew who your father was. We have been honed into a machine of lethal moving parts that you would be wise to avoid if you know what's good for you. We will not be intimidated. We will not back down. We've seen war. We don't want war. But if you want war with the United States of America, there's one thing I can promise you, so help me God. Someone else will raise your sons and daughters. Damn. They're watching.
There you go.
That's pride, ain't it?
That's pride.
Oh, man.
That's prideful as hell right there, boy, to say that, ain't it?
You come this way, boy, you ain't going home.
You ain't going home. Hey, right? Cross that gun line, boss. Cross give me that in Isaiah 14 real quick. Isaiah 14 and 4.
Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 4.
Uh-huh.
That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon.
We just read who the king of Babylon is. Go ahead. That's Edom, the white man. Go ahead.
And say, how hath the oppressor ceased? The golden city ceased.
How is the golden city going to cease? That's the thing. How is it going to cease? Give me that in Isaiah 47. Let's go back to that. Because God's prophesying. Because the pride has deceived them. They're invisible. All their F-16s, their F-15s, their GPS global positioning, their stealth, their ICBM missiles. Nobody can take us down. Isaiah 47, and I want you to read verse 9.
Isaiah chapter 47 and verse 9.
Yep.
But these two things shall come to thee in a moment,
In
one day.
Quick.
The loss of children.
Mm. Those people in the army, gone. Right. Go ahead.
And widowhood.
Uh-huh.
They shall come upon thee in their perfection.
At the right time. When you know why, what's going around there? They ain't powerful enough to take Christ on by himself.
No.
With all that stuff he just
mentioned,
they're not powerful enough to take on Christ by himself.
That's right.
Keep reading.
for the multitude of thy sorceries and for the great abundance of thine enchantments.
Read on.
But thou hast trusted in thy wickedness.
That's their inventions they got, the military power. Go ahead.
Thou hast said, none seeth me.
Uh-huh.
Thy wisdom and thy knowledge, it hath perverted thee. And thou hast said in thine heart, I am and none else beside me.
Nobody's beside me. I am God. And for that reason, for the pride of your heart, God said you got to go. And what I said about they ain't strong enough, jump back. Isaiah 47, verse 3.
Verse 3.
We'll wrap it up. Go ahead.
Thy nakedness shall be uncovered. Yea, thy shame shall be seen. I will take vengeance, and I will not meet thee as a man.
That's why they ain't strong enough. All of that stuff that he just mentioned and boasting about it. Somebody else is going to raise your kids. I dare you to try us. We've got everything. We've got all this money in the FBI and the CIA. Christ said, you ain't even strong enough to deal with me because he's not going to meet you as a man that any of that stuff will work on. It's not going to work on him. You're not powerful enough. But the pride of your heart has deceived you to what's going to happen. When Christ returns, they're going to be afraid, but they're going to do what? They still going to fight. Mm-hmm. And they're going to be destroyed in a moment, in one day.
Quickly. That's right.
And we all going to cry and weep after the Lord as one that lost her only son.
Mm. All right. Raises.
What is a nation? Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models. Nation is unity. Nation is you.
And finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. His word.